Welcome back to Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanjuatco, Trillo. We're talking about building the entrepreneurial character, and still with us is Professor Jay Bernardo. He's the director of the Asian Center for Entrepreneurship and Management Education. He's also the founder of Let's Go Foundation, and Let's Go stands for Leading Entrepreneurs Towards Seizing Global Opportunities. Okay, Professor Jay, before we ended the last segment, you started talking about real-life entrepreneurs who started small but are huge today. Maybe you can tell us more stories, because I know these are the stories that inspire your students and other aspiring entrepreneurs.
A couple of them that even I am truly inspired is, of course, everybody knows in the international arena, everybody knows Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs started in his garage, and that became that story is true. And from there, he worked on the first Apple computer, and then he started doing. He went to Pixar, which he established, and then now back to Apple, and has done products like iPod and the iPad and the iPhone,
the iMac, and the world,
and changed the world. And that's truly inspiring. That shows the innovation and the person that really wants. It's not just a one product type of guy. He really is there to challenge himself to come up with something new. Other people is in Europe. It's Richard Branson.
Okay.
Virgin Records, Virgin Cola.
I read his book. It's amazing how he started. He started out with a magazine or a publication.
That's
and then
right.
He went into music, and then it just exploded, yeah, right?
From magazine to publication to records to airline to cola. I mean, they're unrelated. Now he's coming up with the first trip to the moon. First trip to space. And really unimaginable, and the way that he lives his life as well is he's always challenging himself to come up with something new. In the Philippine setting, there are a couple of people have done that, and some of them are people that you might have heard of the stories already. Henry C, of course, he used to shine shoes, and people, you know, all throughout, there's lots of stories about him. He might not be as active as he is now. Mm-hmm. And you would see that there are his children are the one running those operations.
Correct.
At this point. But it's still the leadership. You see, entrepreneur doesn't have to be the one managing it. But he has to become, he becomes the inspiration behind the whole corporation. And then we have Injap, the latest one. Everybody's now celebrating the success of Injap.
That's how young he is? Is that how he looks today? Yeah, are you kidding me?
I think he's like 32 or 33 years old.
That's crazy.
Yeah, his company, Mang Inasal, was valued at $5 billion.
Right, I heard.
And you see, he started, when he was starting, he was in the province, and he was not even able to get location space. So he operated in the basement of a certain mall. But now he's like...
He's everywhere. He's on every street corner.
Every street corner, and he's bought by Jollibee. Mm-hmm. A dream that almost all the entrepreneurs would like to achieve one day.
Right. I think that's every entrepreneur's dream.
Yeah.
Right? But I remember I was reading something about Steve Jobs before, and I think at some point in his life, he was working either as a graphic artist or a calligrapher or somebody who designed lettering.
Yes.
And
yes.
He was saying that it might sound, and even to him at the time, he thought it was like the most stupidest, most useless job ever. But then when he started with Apple and they have like, they created all these fonts, he realized the value of that, right?
That's right. Yeah, because when you start off, what we usually ask you to do is to take a look at what you're passionate about and take a look at what you are skillful on. And sometimes it's some things, most of the time when you ask entrepreneurs where the source of their new business is, it's an experience that they have experienced before, which maybe did not make sense at that point. But after a while, then they come back to it, and then they make a business out of it.
Right, and there's no accidents as to, you know, the things that happen in your life, they're just not accidents.
They're called serendipitous moments.
Exactly. Okay, shifting on to a slightly different topic.
Yeah.
What would you say are the differences between men and women entrepreneurs?
That's also a very... Some people are saying... Yeah, there's always a 50-50 debate on whether the
woman is better or the man is better.
There are advantages and disadvantages. The men, being more exposed, are very good in opportunity seeking. But the women are very good in operating business and very good in organizing. In business, an entrepreneur goes into, has to have those three qualifications as well. He needs to, the three O's we call it. He needs to be a good originator, he needs to be a good operator, and he needs to be a good organizer. The women have the advantage of being good in operating and organizing. The men, they always like to leave the details to somebody else.
That's so true.
They come up with so many ideas, but some of them don't even get worked upon. But the women, when they work on something, even if it's just one, they will really work on the even in the smallest detail.
Right.
So the only thing, if we can strengthen the women and the men, the men have to not only rely on other people for organizing operating skills, but and the women should start becoming more exposed. The internet gives them that. Mm-hmm. And nowadays, a lot of the business is being done through the internet. So to the advantage of women, I think this is going to be very good for them because it doesn't require them to go out as much.
Right, but they still get the exposure and learn what's out there in the world.
That's right. Even in the olden times, I always tell this analogy because even in the olden times when they said that the entrepreneurs, the first entrepreneurs were fishermen and agriculturists or farmers, if you notice, the men were the ones doing the fishing and the farming, and then they bring back the produce back to the women, and the women will dry it up, fix up the packaging, bring it to the palenque, bring it to the market, sell it, and then account for all the... So who is the entrepreneur between the two?
The woman!
It might be a both combined this time, but the women show characteristics that entrepreneurs have already, mm-hmm. that is required in order to become a successful entrepreneur.
So it's a bit more inbuilt in women, in that aspect.
Yeah, because even in the house, they're so used to managing the household. The men come in and out of the house, while the women take care of. They already manage a small workforce right there. They're managing their maids, they're managing the driver, they're managing the children. And everyday management is like everyday management of a business. So
right, so it's sort of just like an extension of that.
It's an extension of that, yeah.
Okay, you have some classes coming up, right? I think one of them is Building the Entrepreneurial Character, which is what we talked about today. And that's happening
Somewhere in August.
Okay.
We have several classes going on. The Building the Entrepreneurship Character, again, is an introduction for those who want to start up a business. Mm-hmm. It's usually a 25-day course.
Okay.
But you could take it on segments. And that's going to be starting on August 9, I think. We also have courses for those who are already entrepreneurs. And that will start in July 11. Those get master's degree. Okay. Master's of Entrepreneurship. These are for people who have businesses running more than 3 years already. Child of owners that will take over their parents' businesses,
okay,
and that will and that will get a master's degree after 1.5 years.
Wonderful. Okay, and all these classes usually are held at the Ateneo.
This is held
Rockwell
at the Ateneo Rockwell.